few FPS settings issues or FPS issues in the beginning, but that's just because I messed with some Terratech settings. I think we ironed those out. And hello, Flair, how are you doing? Good to see you in chat. We are back again with some more Terratech. I realize I'm pretty sure I actually start most streams with my hands like this, and I really don't know why. It's just become a habit at this point, but that's neither here nor there. Readout's good. We're live. We're all good. No FPS issues that I can see anyway. Hope you guys are good. I am good. How are you, Flair? I hope you're having a great Tuesday. And I am so ready to get back into Terratech. Yesterday, we spent a long time doing missions, a lot of search, destroy, kill as many techs as we could. Today, we're going to dial that back and go a completely different direction because our search and destroy mission, we got destroyed a couple places too. We lost one of our key blocks, which was our steam turbine. Whole point of Steam Valley is to get a ton of those and have those power everything and not worry about our solar power, because nighttime you don't get anything. So we're going to dial it back, we're going to start working on protection, our own turret design, plopping those around, and even some more auto mines so we can get some more resource stations together. So we don't have to worry about finding stuff like carbide or iridite or oilite. Currently doing my chem trig homework, you're going to be my noise while I do it. I'm fine being white noise, just make sure you do good on your homework. Get all those good math vibes from me, I hope. Well, except I don't know how, I don't use too much math anymore in my job now, I think about it, but still. Anyway, without me rambling on anymore, we got our usual time until about 7 o'clock, I think. I think that's when the girlfriend gets home. And, yes, we left off near the trading station here. It's a good spot to actually start, because then we can actually check out what we got in here. We were upgrading our Geocorp license so that we could buy some of these things rather than just hope that they drop. Like, what unlocked in here? Resources unlocked, not really what I was looking for. I was looking for the steam turbines, like I said. I think they're called steam turbines or generators, either way. Caterpillar Track. That's new. I don't remember these tires. Track has very massive carry capacity. It's excellent off-road grip. It's not very fast. Possibly for a harvester in the future. But we're not worried about that right now. We just need to buy a ton of base blocks. We did lose one of those. So we're going to up our money. We're going to up our protection. We're going to make sure we keep some of these too, because we always seem to lose the boosters. And I still haven't had time to actually update OBS to allow a third overlay to go in here. Haha, I'm paying attention, though. What should you be paying attention to more, though? Me or your homework? Not that I'm one to talk, because I do all these things while I'm at work, too. But that makes me a bit of a hypocrite, doesn't it? And I don't have any big silos, so I might have to just buy a couple of these. And we'll call it there. And put that power up. I would say get some power, but it's nighttime, so I don't really have a good way to get power anymore because I don't have the steam turbines. Case in point of why we need to deal with that. And this is actually going to be a good place to start because we do have a couple of carbide streams right here. The veins, I think, actually, not streams. No, it's not even going to highlight it for me. I just have to know what it is. And we'll use this to set up a generic, very small, very quick auto mine. Something that does have some protection, though. We don't want it to be completely unprotected. So, we're going to set it up as such. Like, right at the edge of where it starts becoming red. Doesn't want to go there. I think right there. Nope. Does not want to operate there. So go right here. Alright. We're going to try and get two auto mines on for every one of these. Alright, is that the four block or the... No, it's not the four block. It's the three block. We want a four block. Right there for now, while we start figuring this out, because we don't have a design. I will screenshot this so we don't have to worry about making it again, too. And because of that, I will need a cab on here for the time being. So, there's two things I want to do out of this. I want to stock up some resources, and I also want to sell them when I don't need them. So I will need a cannon. For obvious purposes. Alright, there's one right there. So, I will need a cannon for obvious purposes. I will need to have a refinery as well. Also obvious purposes. Not quite facing the direction I want it to go. But I will also need some silos and a... what the heck was it called? I do have a big mixed pack silo. I don't really care too much about that. I'll just keep a couple small ones. I remember there was a base block for switching off which direction things go. Maybe I never bought one? I'm sure that exists and I never actually bought one. Now I just hope we don't lose this. There's an enemy right there. Ah, we're gonna take him out first. Oh! Okay, no big deal. Not too many weapons, but he does have some very nice wheels. Some very nice Geocorp wheels that used to be, I think, the best wheels, but I'm sure that there's better at this point at this rate. We've been finding out there's a lot of better weapons lately. Alright, these little guys do have the bigger Geocorp blocks too, so that's good. That's good, that's good, that's good. So, what do you have for base blocks, my friend? You surely must have something. Wow, you gotta be kidding me, that's it? Well, we can make do. We'll just incorporate that into our design. And while I'm building this, let's get our charging station up. Quick fuel, and go. So that deck will load, and we really need to deal with this because we have carbide coming out our ears. And that doesn't want to attach there. Well, we thought about that before. We used to be able to put blocks into the side of the terrain and not worry. We'll just put one of these right. Might just have to shift it then. That's fine. We'll just make this a bit more versatile than intended. Like that. Which isn't too bad. I do want to make this more compact. So, unfortunately, I think we might lose an auto mine when I pop that. It might become individual techs. I do want to put a couple of silos on the side here, like that, so that it should feed some into the silos here, so we have a buffer. We'll test that right now. Yep, it does feed some of them into this. When that's full, it'll just start selling them. And there's the alternate conveyor we actually had in our inventory, but it doesn't matter because we got this system. So we can queue up as many of these as we want. That's very much upgradable. So, that means what we really need are a handful of batteries. Some of these stations, if possible. That. Put the cab more towards... Nope. Doesn't want to fit there. Weird. Something's blocking it. I can't do that here either. Oh, I know what the problem is. It's because that's considered separate now. So we'll have some batteries like that. Now, you are not considered separate. You're considered the same tech. So we now know that we can't get too close to these as well. I don't want to queue up too many batteries, but I don't want to leave it completely unprotected either. And a shield bubble, where we can encompass all of this, would be optimal. So I might need to move some of this over instead. Let's think about a different place to put it. Using the batteries, we'll up it a little bit, attach it to the side. That should be center. If not, a little too high. Yeah, too high. Too high, not compact enough. Undo, please. Pop you there. We're gonna put you like that, so we can actually move a lot of these batteries around. Yeah, I know you've been detached. And this is gonna become detached again. That's fine. What a mess, what a mess, what a mess. We need a nearby SCU while we're thinking about this, I think. So, now the cannon's kind of in the way. That. And our... I don't have any more of those, so we'll pop a couple of those on the side. It's a little more compact. Check there. Check where you're at. Way too small and in the wrong place. So I need to think about moving. I need a couple of blocks here to move it around. I might just make use of the batteries. Oh no, undo please. Thank you. No, undo. Dang it. It's not an anchor point. That's what the problem is. That should get the majority of it. It's still too high. Might be able to put it inside. Nope, can't do a cheaty thing like that. So we might just have to live with this. Which covers most of it, but too high. So how do we get it underneath? I don't even think I need these large receivers. It was just for that backlog we had. You can just take that, put a couple on the side like that. Or just one on the side, and that's plenty. We can queue up another silo, so we have three silos worth, which is plenty of carbide for the time being. Now we just need to solidify this design a bit more. Armor plating would make it way too expensive to make. But some more battery would not hurt. So that it can survive through the night. Alright. And now I could put a pacemaker on it, but I think I'm going to make that as a special add-on if I need to, because if these are running all the time, we're not going to have to worry too much about carbide in the near future. Alright, get a good lineup of where I want this to be. Call, let's say, right there is a decent screenshot. So, we're just gonna call this, come on. Oh, no cursor. All right. Stock. Auto mine. And that's good. We should be able to put these down everywhere now. Now, if it becomes an issue, we might have to put wheels on it just to move it around, to position it. But I think that's a good start. Let's go see if we can go pop another one down quick. After taking out this little guy. See, there should be more places out here. And these aren't too expensive, hopefully. Oh, there would be a big guy sitting right there too. Okay. We'll take your wheels. Oh, you're such a bully. I mean, not that I'm one to talk, because I literally just engaged him first, but that's fine. Oh, well, there goes that one. And I'm just going to attach you to something and quickly send you to the storage rather than worry about an SCU, which it probably would have taken the same time as it did to do that. So, we have a carbide stream. There is one behind it. But let's go get some oilite, because we don't have that resource secured at all. Uh-oh. This might be a little mission over here, and I didn't even realize it. Oh, bite me. You are not that strong and you know it. Alright, so we gotta look at these guys too for bad turret design. Aha, lasers? Or ah, lasers. Okay. Little guy down. I'm not exactly sure what mission that was, but I'm guessing it has to do with Hawkeye if he's just randomly there. You can't follow the simplest orders, can you? What was my order? Issue tells you to report to me, what do you do? I can't hear you, boom brain. Baboon brain. You went and took it on yourself to mess up operations, hit the target without authorization, get out of my sight until you've learned to follow orders, complete mission. So did I just fail the mission? Well, how was I supposed to know? They just kind of attacked me. Well, got some Hawkeye stuff out of it. Unintentionally, but I'll take it. And there might be a carbide stream around here, but we're going for oilite today. Then we'll head back to base and do a little bit of turret design. Maybe I can use the hill as cover. Oh, he's not even interested in me. He's interested in the other guy. Yeah, it's okay. He's pretty much done already. So are you. Wow. Balak Bonanza. Ironically, the day we're saying we're not doing search and destroy, we seem to be profiting a lot more. Oh, was that the range of it? Oh, nope, just couldn't pick up that many blocks. Oh, definitely give me those batteries. Don't take those away from me. I don't know what that is, but it just looks like a normal block. And there's totally more batteries over here, too. Oh no, those are also expensive. Alright, soon we'll be in more money than we can deal with. Forget that one block. Nobody cares about that one block. Because I said I don't care about that one block. There we go, perfect. This will be a good tester for if we can just plop this tech down without problems. Let's see. Stock auto mine. Yeah, it might be an issue. Yeah, I might have to put some wheels on it and try and move it. So, give me some general wheels I can use. Maybe even some Geocorp. But I also need some temporary block on the side. And any kind of wheels, just any wheel. Say, Mud Dog? No, those aren't that. We only have two of those. I'd like them to be the same, whatever I pick. These small rugged wheels should do it. Okay. Okay, you're gonna be a bit more of a pain than I thought. Ugh, fine. And then we unanchor. And we will just have to put you right there. A little imbalanced, but just like that. And I think that should work. Take that off, take that off, take that off, take that off, and anchor. To activate the auto mines? Oh, I have to reattach them. Alright, that's not as bad though. Not as bad as I thought it was gonna be. Now we have oil light. Automated oil light at that. Good, good, good. Alright. Onward to danger and adventure. Run him over! I took out all of his weapons? Eh. Everything but his weapons. Yep, there it goes. Wow, it's already filled up. Look at that. When it comes to these storage silos, I might have to put like a dropper next to them if I want to pick these things up. So let's see if I have a dropper available. I might... Dropper, right here. No? No. So, if that doesn't work, then we're just gonna plop this on the side then, I guess. Somewhere. No, it only drops blocks, that's what the problem is. Alright, hold on to it. Just do it like that. You can get all the carbide you want. Awesome. Kind of. Oh, they do drop. Huh. Not from silos. So I might have to change it to something besides silos. Like these tractor pads like I have on me, because then I can actually pick them off. That's good. Now we're going to see our profit increase big time. We need to do some cleanup. We have been stockpiling too many blocks here for a while. Out. And I see an enemy waiting for us right as soon as we get to the other side of our base, too. Oh yeah, he's sitting right there. Alright. Now I have a choice on you. are also not that bad. And chain reaction. Chain reaction, get down, get down. And that's that. After we just cleaned up too, we made a mess. What are you gonna do? My carburetor is one of the blocks I would like to actually keep. So I need to put a cab back on here because I've actually earned a couple cabs. And add that to our silo bin, which has filled up considerably. I thought I put a Luxite. I thought I could, oh wait, I'm not in build mode, that's what it is. So these shouldn't have ever come through. And I honestly don't know why they came through, but they did. Oh, they're clipping. That's what it is, they're clipping. Okay, that's fine. So that means we really can't put another silo there. We're gonna have to put it on the side when we do this. Yep, okay. That is fine. So we need another silo right here. Going to need another filter right here. We can get the face the right way. Not quite, there we go. Okay. You to face that way. And we need our down conveyor there. Reverse direction. And give me one of those carbide blocks if I can reach them, that'd be great. Put one there so I can reach it. Put the filter right here. Perfect. So now we can actually save carbide blocks. Wait. Scratch that. I already had a spot for them. Oh, well. Guess we'll just change the filter to filter nothing for the time being, because I know I actually have a spot for that. That works. We'll change it to something else later. Come on, you. And I never really wanted those to begin with. Yeah, that SCU really doesn't pick up anything. Got some plumbite there. Nice. If you would get rid of that wood, that would be great. Good. I really do wish I could armor this a little better, but I've had a couple design problems with that. That's whatever. So now we need to work on a turret design. And ideally, if I did have enough steam turbines, I would just put them right on a steam turbine and let them get their power all the time. But unfortunately, we're not that blessed. So we'll do our design kind of right in the middle of our base here. Not just so we're next to the SCU up the top here, but we'll also defend this area here. So I need a rotating anchor is the first thing. And I do have a rotating anchor, but just the one. I kind of want to take inspiration from the Black Totem when we fought that. That was a hard son of a gun. I mean, the problem with any turret, though, is that you're going to be able to defeat it if you have more than one enemy at the same spot. I'm almost thinking, now that we have these big geocorp blocks, we can... I don't think these are centered on one, they're centered on two, which kind of is not ideal, now I think about it. But we can make use of these GSO 5-4 blocks, because they're more common than the 5 blocks. Come on. Come on, get up there. Good enough. And then we'll take the Geocorp long blocks. Not like that. You gotta go down more. Come on. I want you up a little more than that, though. Yep, just like that on the other side, too. We'll use that. That should work pretty good. We'll have to put a cabin here that is got AI. And I'll also need a cabin here so I can play with this while I'm designing it. Good. And we don't care about radars because we're not going to man this thing. This is unmanned. But we do want a ton of stud lasers on the front. And this should be a big enough platform for it. Especially if I do that. Might not even need to do that. So, stud lasers. Just an absolute wall of them. Not the strongest, but they are cheap. We do get a lot of them. Now, unfortunately, we need a way to power this. I don't want you to turn randomly like that. Okay, so we do know that the AI is picking up, which is good. But I need you to face the correct way. Because otherwise you're going to face backwards every time. I need a couple batteries in here, but this isn't going to be enough. So it leads me to believe I shouldn't even be using geocore blocks. And I don't think he can turn if I do it like that. But I can put a couple on the back like that if I want to. Yeah, unfortunately there's no way to charge it now. I wish I could just leave that unanchored. But I might have to put one there and just let it charge up at night. But that's not nearly enough power, so I'm not happy with that. We need to incorporate power more, but not make it too expensive. Kinda like that. And he also doesn't have a bubble, which is a big problem too. We haven't put a bubble on him yet. And I've clicked off once more. Where are... Okay, shield bubbles are what we're going for. Incorporate the entire guy. Which is good. So we got 9 batteries, which is good. Put a... I said I didn't want to use 4 blocks, so I won't use 4 blocks. I'll use 2, 2, and 1. We will need... I don't know if those work facing the wrong way. Might just even... do it like that. Gonna look a little weird with the antenna on top. I hope that's enough power to get him going, at least to get a charge up, and then once he's charged, we're good. Take some more 2 blocks. Like that. Pop a 1 on the bottom. And then we're gonna have to use armoring. And I don't have any huge armor. I might need to see if I can buy more of that now that I did it like this. Geocorp, I have a couple of these small armors, but I have these large shock plates as well. Don't have a ton of those either. So if I go with the small shock plates, those are gonna work well. Keep him armored on all sides. Just getting this ring armored. It might almost be better to just take out the fact that we have a 2 block here. Pop a 1 block there. Get that going. Have you in the center, and then we could... Then we could what? Still not what I'm going for. might just flat out not use Geocorp. But I need something that's stronger than GSO at the beginning, too. So I might not have a choice. Might have to. 2, 2, 1. Need those big shock plates because they are cheaper for me to get because I have they're very abundant. And then line the rest with. I guess we can just use the medium armor plates if I had enough. Shift them back maybe like that. And then just have these overlap on the side. Doesn't look the greatest because of that though. We do have a weak spot up top there. But I might be better off changing that for another one of these power stations then. Plop that on there. Nah, don't do that, please. I'm still working on you. Alright, we do have this little row here that I can probably plop some cannons on for an extra oomph. Little bit extra. Because I seem to have a love affair with these cannons. Do that, take you off. Send you back. But I will need to take a screenshot of this guy if I just want to use him like that, too. He seems to periodically move. Okay. So yeah, we're going to need to put a cab on him if we want to take a screenshot anyway. Where's the cabs? There's the cabs. Just when we go to take it, when we go to actually implement this guy, we'll need to remember to take the cab off here. And that should be a pretty good turret that's not too expensive. Just make sure he charges up okay, too. Make sure the bubble reaches everything. Alright. In the bubble, armored on all sides, except the top. The front's got some pretty durable blocks on it. Minus this one. Which I guess could be one more stud laser. But do we even need this two block here? No. At that point, it's just extra. I'm using twos and ones because they're cheaper and more abundant, even though they're not quite as strong. And I hope that it's not an issue that this is exposed down below. If that becomes an issue, we'll just have to do that as a rev, like a revision. Alright, and take a screenshot. Recall this. Oh, what we could say, stock turret. Save that. And then when we go to take him off, we will plop on another cannon. Like that. And that should be good to go. Plop him here. And we can go see if we can plop a couple more of these turrets down in a second. Maybe we can even give him a tester with an enemy on the side. I was going to take over all of Steam Valley here when I was planning the base, which maybe it's good for the future, but right now we're having a hard enough time just keeping this section alive, so we're going to expand on that side for the most part and develop that. We really need to focus on keeping what we have alive and then expanding. Alright, we don't have any tester guys, unfortunately. And we do have quicker carbide to access over here, too. So maybe it'd be good to put one of those auto mines down here, too. So we can access that carbide quicker. But we're always in the area, so we're going to load that up. And like I just said, we need to focus our efforts in Steam Valley in a more compact manner. So that's going well. Getting a ton of money. And now I need to place another turret down. Because this guy is technically a turret on his own. But it wouldn't be bad to test out another one in the area where enemies like to spawn a lot. And that would probably be around this section here. So I'll plop a turret right here as long as I... Okay, except I'm missing rotating anchor, some armor, and a cab. One of those AI cabs, so we're gonna have to go buy some. Buy some, stock them up, and maybe even just make them. If we don't find one there, that's what we're going to have to work on then. We're going to have to make a fabrication process here. And actually get that kicking. That's going beautiful. We'll pick up some of that while we're at it too. So I will probably just plop on a couple temporary tractor pads. That's a really big pad. That's not what I'm looking for. Tractor pad, where are you? I don't seem to see it. There you are. So, we got one, two. Take that for our carbite. Probably don't even need that second one now I think about it. Just the one will do. Oh, come on. You aren't getting away from me. You're quicker than you think. I run circles around you, little guy. Dragon Scale, how you doing? And Flying Ferrets, good to see you two in there. How are both your days going? Flare's in here too. He's doing some homework this time, but he's here. He's definitely here. Blast him up. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Our big old tech here can take out that no problem. And unfortunately, we do not have any more AI cabs ready. Great, caught new legendaries. Oh yeah, you're big into the Pokemon Go, aren't you? What legendaries did you get today? Was it Raikou, perhaps? Was it me you saw? What do we have? Ooh. Oh, gotta stock up on the mustaches. Did I lose my mustache? Nope. Still have it. Yeah. And only two people, one beside me. Geothermal generator. Yes! Oh my god, yes! Oh, we lost that before, and now we got one. Yes. Oh, good day. Good day indeed. And remote charger for quicker charging. Here, why don't you charge me up while we're sitting? Oh, wait. No thermal supply. Right. Good. Mine's good. Making dinner, then getting on myself after. Oh, getting on stream. Okay. I'm sorry, it was so vague, I had no idea what you were saying for a second there. It wasn't anything bad, trust me, don't worry about that. Alright, cannons, because we're over here. Yes, sorry, oh, it's fine. Hey Block, how you doing? Wow, chat is filled today. Look at all the colors. How you doing? I think you just saw that we bought a new geothermal generator. We could finally replace that one we lost so poorly yesterday. And yeah, we're gonna just have to craft up some things. Alright, that means we gotta get on that crafting. Alright. So while we're over here, give me some of this. Please and thank you. Good enough. Are you still beaming over that attention you got from the devs on the tech block? For those of you who don't know, Block's been here a couple times right now, and he loves to play with TerraTech, especially the R&D center. And the devs had tweeted out one of his techs that he completely decimated their challenge, the block, in one shot. That moment you wow the devs at their own game is amazing. Alright. And that's going up good. Stocking some of those up. Not all, most. And we're gonna have to actually work on crafting system now. So for that to happen, we're probably going to need to get rid of a couple things. That's not where I wanted you. I'm probably going to put you in build mode. So, we haven't stocked up everything. We can always raise the tower more for other stuff. We'll just put you two down here for now. I did want the, the crafting process to end over towards the SCU so I could just drop it and they can get sucked up. And that was my whole idea, is to have the at least a small SCU as a central point where everything gets fabricated and it just... And our turret's already on it. Well, good to know he's actually targeting. So I need to think of how I want to do this. It would probably be best... You know, it'd almost be best just to not do that right now and just get a crafting system going right here. So I could just drop it on the side here, have it go into another SCU if I'm really that into the idea. Rather than make a central point, have everything get attacked, and then boom, everything doesn't work. We'll just take it machine by machine. So I'm looking for a lot of the manufacturing blocks. And plenty of conveyors. Okay, good. I might have to change the way you are going. Alright, forget that. We're gonna use... Come on. There we go, use that trick. Keep it down below. So everything funnels to this point. If I can get you to attach that way, we can actually take those to the side. A small fabrication operation going. Take care of that. We don't even really need these little bits here. Keep you on overdrive. And we'll grab a cannon, which not a cannon. We don't need a cannon. We need a fabricator. Which I should have tons of those. A component factory. Fabricator as well. So maybe I don't know if I'll need a component factory anytime soon. Wow, that is a lot bigger than I was expecting it to be. So we'll just move everything down to the bottom level and deal with it from there. It might just be better to... No, don't do that. Dang it. Click off again. Might be better to just use a down conveyor. Bring it down to my level and deal with it from there rather than try and use trickery to get it down. So, that's coming down here. If it is called, we'll deal with it. If it's not, we'll have to sell it, unfortunately. So I gotta think about that too. Oh, wait. But if I do it like this, they won't ever come out. So, I'm incorrect in thinking that I can just take it right there. They need to come out the back of the silos, which was the whole point of this machine, now I think about it. Darn it. Yeah, where's a temporary SCU? The whole point was for one side to load and the other side to unload. So for that to happen... We would need probably some down conveyors for one. Down conveyors. One conveyors. Like that. Down, 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 down. Zooming. Down, down, down. Keep going down. I have no idea where that one went, or that one. Alright, try to get these all going the same direction if possible. Alright, so those are going down. Those are going down. And that's kind of going where I want it to do, but not really. So I might need to figure out... Might be better to go up. Have you go to the side like that, I guess. Yeah, might be better to do that. And rather than do this, we will have another conveyor. Go to the side, going that way. No, going the other way. You will feed that way. Okay, so everything's feeding to the top point now. And I will need a way to shift where these go. Like an up conveyor. Unfortunately, it's not taking the other side right now. So, thinking for the future, we need that. Probably a conveyor going like, come here, like that. Just go around the edge. Okay, I gotta take a pause on that for a second because I am tired of listening to that turret. Alright, what's your crux, my friend? My crux is that you're in my way. Oh, you freaking kidding me. There we go. Come on, come on, come on, come on. There you go. Alright, park your booty there. What, you wanna try them? Oh, there's a couple of them up there. Alright, I'll act as your bridge. Can you come down now? No, 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 no. Well, there's my answer. My answer is no, many times over. You're almost done. Take you out. And then take you out. Oh, you're still not dead either. Come on. So that's one. That's two. Right there with the mortars. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Yeah, perfect. And there's our problem child. Because we're in the perfect spot to power up the... Where's my geothermal generator? Where is my geothermal generator I just bought? Oh, right there. And charge it up. Not much faster on the charging, though, is it? Alright, we need to speed this process up. Yeah, really not faster. Dang, I had high hopes for GeoCorp on that. We'll get there, and then we'll take out that little spider guy in the corner over there. More carnage! We can't go the entire stream without some carnage. Alright, good. Get out of my face, let's go! Come at me! Come at me, bro! Kenny! Oh, Kenny, okay. We got this. Oh crud, what time is it? It's almost 7, actually, so we'll probably end off on killing Kenny here. I know time, I'm trying to finish up. I can't hear you right now, I got the headphones on. I'm killing Kenny, I'm sorry. I'm not sorry at the same time. Because he's died so many times, let's kill him once more. Come on. That's one. Almost one. He's got a sneaky cab somewhere. Alright. And, El Boost, go! Take him out. Knocked him off his wheels. Perfect. Drill you to death. Perfect. Pick up these wheels. Alright, and that's actually going to be the end for today's stream, too. So, thank you to everybody who stopped by. I have to go make some pizza with my girlfriend here for dinner. But don't think I'm going to leave you hanging. I will find someone off the Discord to send you guys to. Give me a brief moment here to save everything up. Yeah, rip, right? Have a nice day. You too. And as a reminder, we are not streaming tomorrow, but we are streaming Thursday. So you have that to look forward to. We are playing some more Terror Tech, but we also have another bonus stream coming. It's still a little bit tentative right now. We are thinking about doing it on Saturday. Don't have a time, don't have any details, so keep your eye on the Twitter or the Discord, and I'll keep those details there. But we will mix it up. Instead of doing Terror Tech on our bonus stream, we'll take a break and do some PSO too. Now, if you haven't seen that, we've done it in the past. You can check out the YouTube channel if you need a little taster. If not, you're in for a real treat. It's almost like Monster Hunter if you need something to compare it to. But without me rambling on anymore, let's see who I can send you on off to. Ah, here's someone we haven't gotten to host or raid for a while. Ordosan's going on right now with some Purgatory Fall. Real nice guy, and I'm sure you guys will enjoy seeing him stream and play. So we're going to send you on over to him, and I will see you Thursday. See you next time.